give us the name of your business, who you are, what your business is about.
So I'm Deirdre Lambright, and my business is Sweets for Days. It's an online baking business. I make cookies, cupcakes, and cake pops.
I'm Annabelle Schultz. I run Jackie's Instagram, Furkowski Cuts.
My name's Jackie Kofsky. I do the cutting of the business.
My name's Annalise Stewart.
I'm Amanda Jackson.
We do Just the Dip. Amanda runs the Instagram, and I do the nails.
So today I'm going to be making Rocky Road cookies, which is like the ice cream, you know, walnuts and marshmallows, but in a cookie.
So do you have a favorite client that's come in?
Yeah. Probably actually, though. She doesn't care.
Honestly, these might be my favorite. We did her nails on Wednesday, this exact same color.
So I was sitting last night, we were hanging out, and she goes, yeah, I guess you're doing it. So I just popped them all off. She's like tearing it off.
What's your favorite part of running your own business?
I would say the baking, but also the freedom. I feel like that's kind of a good and a bad thing. Sometimes I may not do everything the way I should be doing it, but also I get to make all those decisions. I enjoy the responsibility.
I think it's just like this social aspect, because so many people come.
And it's really fun meeting people.
Yeah, and we can be creative. We were straight up just like, wait, we could totally make apparel. And people were like, that's such a great idea.
Honestly, I think it's meeting the people.
Mm-hmm.
Not only can I make my own schedule, but when I'm at the appointments, I'm just meeting a bunch of really cool girls, and I get to sit there and talk to them and hang out with them the whole time, so it doesn't even really feel like I'm working.
A lot of the girls that started getting their nails done, I had already kind of been friends with, but now like I get to sit and chat with them more and get to know them better.
What was your biggest setback in getting it underway?
Just time.
I'd say like locations.
Definitely feeling like I didn't have enough knowledge or I wasn't ready.
It really limits the amount that I can do. So it really comes down to time and also being a student on top of it all.
Moving indoors is a little tough. Also just, I feel bad sometimes if my roommates are studying and I'm bringing like random people taking up the bathroom.
I just kept telling myself to push it back because I wasn't ready. I didn't feel prepared enough to own my own business. So definitely my parents, like their kind of motivation, and just realizing that it's not going to be perfect before you start. You kind of just have to take things as they come.
What's been like the biggest driving factor that encourages you to keep going?
I think at this point it's just like fun. That's kind of the whole point of it. Like,
so we just made hats. We're going to place an order pretty soon.
So yeah. It's just going to be like a joke.
It was kind of a joke, yeah.
Say like
snip, snip, chop, chop, snippity, chippity, snop, chop, which is our business slogan.
Ever since I started doing this, I really enjoyed doing the nails. It's a very relaxing process. I didn't want to work a job, so I just saw an opportunity to make money doing something that I enjoyed.
Having my own set in stone actual bakery somewhere and wanting to have multiple around the country, that's definitely a motivator. I would say that it's part of because I enjoy it so much that I push myself to do it even while I'm in school. I guess in the end, I was just like, I need to do it or I'm never going to.